Today on Good Morning Maine, the cleanup is now underway following the latest winter storm to batter the coast. Plus, an Enfield man is facing court action this week following an alleged domestic violence incident that ended with a high-speed police chase. And state lawmakers are considering term limits for members of Congress. Good morning, everyone. I'm Craig Coulson. Emma Smith is on vacation this week. We thank you for joining us. We'll have all the day's news coming up, but first, check on the forecast, and it looks like kind of a quiet start to the work week. Lots of sunshine today before yet another storm moves in and maybe brings us a few inches of snow. Overall, not a monster storm by any means, but it could cause some slippery driving conditions tomorrow. For more on what we can expect, let's turn things over to Devin Biggs.
Alrighty, thank you very much. Happy Monday, your first weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. As we get into things this morning, we have some advisories already posted ahead of our next system that will be moving in. This right here is a winter storm watch that's posted until 2 a.m. Wednesday morning. The snow's going to be moving in throughout the day Tuesday, and a part of Tuesday evening, so some accumulating snow possible, especially in this area, though, although most of us will see some kind of accumulating snow before it wraps up. We also have a small craft advisory up through today until 4 p.m. along the coast because of active surf along the coast. As for the radar and satellite, we're looking pretty quiet out there now, just some clouds passing through. A few returns up on the radar as well, but otherwise I think we're staying dry out there with at least a partly cloudy sky, and will remain partly cloudy throughout the daytime period today. So we will see some sunshine as we have this system that has since tracked off towards the north and east. Some more activity near Washington, D.C., but otherwise for us, we're looking pretty good. We will be under a partly cloudy sky today, as Futurecast indicates. Later on tonight, more clouds will begin to approach as that next system begins to get a little bit closer. As for the winds, a few areas reaching up to around 5 to 10 miles per hour at times, maybe a few higher gusts along the coast, but things will start to calm down later on tonight. But as this next system moves in, maybe some more gusty winds to watch out for. So that hourly forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period, a lot of sunshine, partly cloudy otherwise later this afternoon, temperatures in the 30s. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up.
All right, thank you very much, Devin. A little breaking news to tell you about that happened this morning. I think it was around 6:40 this morning. Rescuers were called to the Glenburn side of Pushaw Lake. That's where a snowmobiler apparently drove through the ice this morning. We don't have a lot of details, but we were listening to the police scanner, and it sounded like that rider made it out of the water okay and was up on the ice walking around waiting for rescuers to arrive. Just really a symptom of the dangerous ice conditions that are out there. We just haven't had the cold weather, so if you are planning to go out doing any riding or ice fishing, just be extremely careful. Just last week, I saw people posting pictures from Pushaw Lake, and they still had some open water in some areas, so still pretty dangerous out there in some places. Meanwhile, the Maine Department of Marine Resources is now assessing damage all along Maine's coast. According to a spokesperson from the DMR, Commissioner Patrick Kelleher, the DMR surveyed the Midcoast on Saturday and witnessed unprecedented damage from the back-to-back storms. This includes damage to docks and wharfs, which the department says are vital for the fishing and aquaculture industries, along with Maine's economy. These images provided by the department are of Chipman's Wharf in Millbridge and also damaged in New Harbor, taken after Wednesday's storm. The DMR and the Department of Economic and Community Development are expected to discuss the impacts of the storms that are affecting island and coastal communities. That will take place during a free webinar on Tuesday. More information on that webinar can be found on our website at foxbangor.com. In Belfast, residents say they were hit hard by both storms. Our Grace Blanchard spoke with members of the Belfast community as they begin to move forward following the flooding there.
We know there are going to be more storms coming, so the big question for me is, what do we do about all this?
That's the question on many people's minds after coastal communities were slammed by this week's powerful wind and rainstorms.
It's bad. I've never seen it. I've been here over 20 years in Maine, and I've never seen the water this high. I've never seen this kind of erosion and damage.
As you can see, it's quite a mess here in the Belfast Harbor as water is still at an incredibly high level following the storm.
It's the worst I've ever seen it down here. I've never seen our beer garden completely underwater.
The flooding damaged multiple businesses along the harbor.
I mean, it was a record. We had 38 inches of water in the building, and probably out here in the beer garden, the deepest point was probably a couple feet deep. So,
on Sunday, locals were seen gathering debris.
picked up some pieces here. We picked up some pieces down at the Searsport Wharf.
And assisting those feeling brave enough to launch their boats into the harbor again.
Where I docked my boat was destroyed, and that big deck was destroyed. So if I had left my boat in the water, even if she had been okay, I wouldn't have been able to access her.
Several community members say it's going to take a village to restore Maine's working waterfronts.
It's Maine. You wait until it's over, and then you fix it and clean up and do what you have to do.
I think it's a strong community, and I think everyone's going to put things back together and get back to business. So that's our hope.
In Belfast, Grace Blanchard for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Similar scenes taking place all along Maine's coast. Well, the storm also tore through homes and streets down in Camp Ellis, destroying houses and washing up debris that could take days to clear out. Asia Reed with that story.
Following Saturday's historic storm, folks here in Saco are finally able to pick up the pieces left behind.
Well, we just got here, but we're trying to figure out how much damage our house got and just get things, the pipes winterized and whatnot.
Tim Chu is a resident here at Camp Ellis in Saco. He's checking out the damage to his home from Saturday's storm for the very first time.
We lost the back deck, the stairs going up to the front of the back, and then I know the plumbing underneath got ripped out.
Homes at the edge of the ocean here couldn't escape damage. The bottom half of this house was completely destroyed. There's a gaping hole where a large wall and window once stood.
A lot of these houses have been here for decades, and it's really sad to see all the destruction.
Henry Swenson and Justin Abramowitz traveled all the way from Boston to check out the aftermath.
It's bad. Definitely some of the worst damage I've seen. I'm a storm chaser, so I've seen some pretty bad damage across New England. But this is definitely up there.
Don't notice how much power it has until you look at the aftermath, you know?
Powerful waves pushed all this sand into the street. Crews are here with bulldozers clearing it out.
Just seeing the sand just come up here and rise like several feet, covering the foundations of your houses is really unbelievable.
It's amazing how much it moved thousands and thousands of pounds of sand all the way inland here with all the rocks and everything.
In a statement after the storm, the mayor of Saco, Jody MacPhail, says she's never seen damage like this in her lifetime.
Emergency workers want to remind folks to not go down any closed roads. You could be putting yourself and emergency workers in danger.
That was Asia Reed reporting. Meanwhile, down in South Portland, plans are already underway to rebuild three historic fishing shacks at Willard Beach. They were swept away by the latest storm over the weekend. This video shows the first of the three falling into the ocean at high tide on Saturday and the debris washing ashore. Then the other two shacks faced a similar fate about an hour later, being carried away by the waves. The shacks at Fisherman's Point were the last tie to a long fishing history dating back to the early 1700s. One person who recently moved to South Portland says it's clear how much people care about that piece of local history.
As I was walking by, an older woman who was probably in her 70s, she was pretty broken up. She said this was her childhood had just been erased. So for the fact that I've only been tied to them for a couple months just moving to South Portland, I can imagine that they're pretty important to the rest of the community, too.
A Fisherman's Point was the first wharf in Portland Harbor and was a major trading site for hundreds of years. The shacks, originally built on the beach, were moved to Fisherman's Point in the 1880s. The local historical society says architects took detailed drawings of the buildings before the storm, and those drawings will be used in the rebuilding effort in a process that will begin this week. The U.S. Coast Guard, meanwhile, says a fishing vessel ran aground down in Cape Elizabeth, one of many. The Coast Guard received a Mayday call at around 12:30 Saturday morning, and four people were on board at the time. Crews were able to rescue them around 1:30 in the morning. There's no word yet on whether there were any injuries. The boat called the Terra Lynn 2 currently remains aground because crews were not able to get it during the storm. The boat was headed to Portland at the time, one of many boats that either ran aground for whatever reason, some of them just broke free and ended up drifting during the storm. The storm also made its way through Bar Harbor, but some are saying it made much less of an impact in town compared to last week's storm. Our Callie Warren spoke with local businesses about what they experienced on Saturday.
Bar Harbor residents were caught in a storm once again this weekend. After heavy rain and winds caused flooding in the area on Wednesday, some locals say they feel lucky to have experienced less of an impact on Saturday.
So far, knock on wood, it's not quite as bad as the last storm. I'm just hoping nothing else gets broken. You know, everyone's safe. And that's what I'm hoping for.
Due to the conditions, some are urging caution while driving. For Mia Callahan, who commutes from Ellsworth to Bar Harbor for work, safety is a priority in extreme weather.
Know what you are getting yourself into if you have to drive or if you choose to drive. A lot of areas have local Facebook pages that have traffic reports from people on the ground that you can keep an eye on. Sometimes routes are closed, and knowing about those in advance can make your travel a lot more less stressful.
Despite the weather, some businesses chose to remain open. For Patrick Conley, manager of the Stadium Pub and Coffee Shop, it was worth it to provide warmth to locals during the storm.
Most people come to Bar Harbor, I think, to go through the park and do a lot of outdoor stuff. So rain sort of dampens that. And a lot of times people will end up, here, coffee, lobster rolls, breakfast sandwiches, stuff like that.
Storm damage can be reported to the Maine Emergency Management Agency. For more information, visit our website at foxmangor.com. In Bar Harbor, I'm Callie Warren, with ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
In other news this morning, an Enfield man was arrested after a high-speed pursuit over the weekend, according to the Penobscot County Sheriff's Office. At around 3 o'clock on Saturday afternoon, deputies responded to a report of a felony domestic violence assault in Enfield. Police say 24-year-old Zachary Tomlinson fled the scene while deputies were on their way. Tomlinson was then found heading north on Route 2 in Lincoln and was reportedly pursued at high speed through both Lincoln and Chester before being apprehended on the Sweet Road in Lincoln. After searching Tomlinson, deputies say they found a loaded 9mm handgun on his body. Tomlinson was arrested and taken to the Penobscot County Jail with charges of felony domestic violence assault, eluding an officer, and also operating without a license, among other offenses. Bangor police are looking for a pair of suspects following a series of smash-and-grab burglaries. According to Sergeant Jason McCambley, the suspects are believed to be using a gray-colored Chrysler Pacifica with a rear license plate displaying four numbers and two letters. Sergeant McCambley says the suspect vehicle parks close to other cars, allowing the burglars to use the sliding door to break into other vehicles without ever stepping outside. The vehicle is also suspected of being involved in a similar car burglaries in Hancock County. Anyone with information should call the Bangor Police Department. Officials suspect an electrical malfunction caused a fire in Fairfield over the weekend. Fire crews were called to an old farmhouse on Gagnon Road just after 1 o'clock Sunday morning. Firefighters found flames coming from the second floor and attic area and worked quickly to stop the fire from spreading. According to the Morning Sentinel, the Red Cross has been called in to help the two residents who were displaced by the fire. Officials say the damage is too severe to determine exactly how it started, but they say it appears an electrical problem sparked the flames in Fairfield. Well, one person was transported to the hospital after crashing a tractor-trailer truck into a pole along Route 3 on Sunday. According to the Montville Fire Department, multiple crews responded to the scene around 4 o'clock Sunday morning after a driver for Hannaford, reportedly traveling east toward Belfast on Route 3, lost control of the vehicle and hit that pole. The truck ended up on its side about 45 to 50 feet off the embankment. Another vehicle also became involved when a Dead River truck wound up entangled in the low-hanging wires from the broken pole. The road was closed for several hours as crews worked to clear the down wires, and that tractor-trailer is expected to be removed from the ditch sometime today. Drivers will want to watch out for that. Officials say the driver was taken to the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. All right, the time now is 8:14. Coming up next on Good Morning Maine, state lawmakers are holding discussions to consider new term limits for members of Congress. We'll have the story. But first, another check of today's weather forecast. It looks like a quiet day ahead, partly cloudy conditions with highs near 31 degrees. Mostly cloudy overnight with lows dropping down to around 16. Tomorrow, we can expect some snow showers, perhaps several inches in some locations. The highs tomorrow, around 30 degrees.
I had a slip and fall accident. I wasn't sure what to do. Joe Bornstein's office handled everything. The experience was much better than what I expected. They were very professional and responsive to all my questions and concerns. I highly recommend the law offices of Joe Bornstein. Over 25,000 victories for injured Mainers just like me. If you've been injured in an accident, call Joe It's that easy. Tell them you mean business. Call Joe today for a free case evaluation. There's never a fee unless you win.
Silver Fox Automotive is a family-owned and operated company with more than 30 years of experience. We are originally from the county and offer competitive prices and promise you will be completely satisfied with our work. We offer a stress-free experience to both our new and returning customers. We only use parts from reputable brands to ensure your vehicle is safe to drive. Here at Silver Fox, there will always be a friendly face to greet you. Come see us at 2004 Odlin Road in Herman.
Spectrum Mobile brings you our best deal to start the new year. Now you can get unlimited mobile for $15 per line. Switch to Spectrum Mobile Unlimited for just $15 per line with no added taxes or hidden fees and no contracts. Save over $1,400 for the first year. Call 855-231-6922. Spectrum Mobile includes nationwide 5G and the fastest wireless speeds with unlimited talk, text, and data. Switch to Spectrum Mobile Unlimited for just $15 per line. Call 855-231-6922 or visit a Spectrum store near you.
Sarah's House is a cancer hospitality house. It basically serves people on their cancer journey. As they're battling cancer, they have to come down to Brewer, to the treatment center here, and they can come from all different places in the state, as far away as Eastport to Aroostook County even. We've had guests come from all over. So if you live greater than 30 miles away, you have a place to come and be at home while you receive treatment. And really, usually guests become lifelong friends. So it's a connection unlike anything you'll ever see, and it's a place unlike anywhere I've ever been.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. Tensions were high as the Government Oversight Committee debated what actions they should recommend to help solve Maine's child welfare crisis. The committee has spent much of its off-season hearing from Maine's child caseworkers and continuing its deep dive into the failures of Maine's child welfare system. Senator Jeff Timberlake, who has sat on the Government Oversight Committee for over 6 years, was noticeably frustrated with the lack of action during that time.
For 6 years, I've sat here. For 6 years, we've talked about it. For 6 years, nothing happened. I'm very scared, Representative, that if we continue at the same process we're at, and we wait for another month for the department to give us information, and we wait for another month, we're going to have walked out of here. I'm going to feel, not saying the rest of this committee, I'm only going to speak for Jeff Timberlake, that I'm going to have walked out of here a failure.
He was largely in agreement on a number of different reforms, including improving recruitment and retention within the Department of Health and Human Services, also investing more in services for families, and separating the Office of Child and Family Services from DHHS. More on that to come. Well, term limits for Congress were discussed Friday at the State House. Our Augusta reporter Corey Bouchard was there and explains about the situation.
These two amendments would do wonders for our nation, and that's what the VLA will be voting on this morning.
Ken Quinn is the regional director for U.S. Term Limits, an organization that advocates for calling an Article 5 convention with all 50 states for the purpose of enacting congressional term limits and campaign finance restriction amendments to the U.S. Constitution.
What we want is to have the states have this discussion. We know Congress is not going to limit their own term of office.
The Veterans and Legal Affairs Committee discussed and voted on a joint resolution that would call for two separate Article 5 conventions to address the issues. Several committee members questioned if the conventions could be restricted to their topics.
I recognize that there is significant debate in good faith from both sides of this issue as to whether or not parameters could be considered and whether or not a convention could be controlled or whether it would run away to all sorts of other unrelated topics.
Senator Rick Bennett, the sponsor of the resolution, assured committee members that protections for a productive convention are in place.
The Constitution is very clear that an Article 5 convention is different and well-defined under the Constitution as opposed to a general constitutional convention.
Quinn adds that currently six other states have signed on to the convention, but even if they get to the 34 required states to agree, that doesn't necessarily mean a convention will be held.
Now, how this is going to play out is, as we get closer to the two-thirds, Congress is going to finally read the writing on the wall, and they will preempt the process and propose the amendments to avoid the states doing it to them. This will probably go down in our history as the fastest ratified amendment our country has ever seen.
The joint resolution passed the committee by a vote of 6-3. It will now make its way for a full vote of the legislature. At the State House, I'm Corey Bouchard for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Senator Susan Collins made a stop by St. Joseph Hospital in Bangor to see and discuss the impact of federal investments secured for the hospital. Over $700,000 of the funding was used to upgrade the hospital's mammogram image equipment. The new equipment offers a more comfortable experience for patients of all ages and sizes, while also allowing the hospital to expand its hours of operation.
And this is a great hospital that does so much good for so many people. And being able to help them at a time of fiscal constraints for healthcare and in Washington means a lot to me.
Additionally, $1.5 million of the funding was used to improve inpatient and age-friendly care. Those improvements include the incorporation of ADA-compliant accessibility features, expanded end-of-life care rooms, and also a more calming environment overall. They do a lot of good work there at St. Joseph Hospital. The time now is 8:21. Coming up after the break, some Americans are awakening this morning to record-breaking cold weather. We'll hear about the dangerous conditions. Plus, a man known as the Gilgo Beach serial killer is expected to be charged with killing yet another person. All the latest as Good Morning Maine continues.
Roto-Rooter has served the greater Bangor area and beyond for 35 years, offering plumbing, hydrojetting, snaking, descaling, video inspection, and grease interceptor cleaning services. For all your residential and commercial clogs, call Roto-Rooter today, 990-1234.
And away go troubles down the drain. Roto-Rooter.
10 years from today, Lisa Schneider will become the undisputed leader of a ginormous pack of dogs. Rescue dogs, to be exact. A second act made possible by the career reskilling courses Lisa's already taking now with AARP to help make sure her income lives as long as she does, so she can finally run with the big dogs and the small dogs who just think they're big dogs. That's why the younger you are, the more you need AARP.
Hi, this is Jim with Lowry & Associates.
Some guy slid across the center line and hit my daughter. The cops said the guy was driving way too fast for the snowy conditions.
I'm so sorry you guys are going through this. Is your daughter okay?
She just had surgery yesterday. Is there any way you can come meet us at the hospital?
Absolutely. I can meet you at the hospital right now.
Lowry & Associates came to the hospital and settled my daughter's case for $250,000.
I'm Jim with Lowry & Associates. Call us. We win for you.
Excitement comes standard with the Honda Accord. And so does a turbocharged engine. Sophisticated. High-tech. Style that enhances functionality. Stand out with the Honda Accord. From Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Contact your Honda dealer today or shop online.
Welcome back, everyone. Now to the cold weather turning downright dangerous for millions of Americans this morning. Wind chills near the Great Lakes will remain below zero this morning, and it's not much warmer as far south as Texas. ABC's Rhiannon Alley has more.
This morning, 100 million Americans are waking up to an Arctic blast bringing snow, ice, and record-setting cold. In Texas, the power grid operator is asking residents to conserve electricity as below freezing temperatures push farther south. Wind chills overnight in Dallas were expected to dip to -7.
Wind chill alerts are stretching from Montana to the southern tip of Texas. Some cities in Iowa feeling like -30.
In Mississippi and Alabama, people are urged to wrap exposed pipes in their homes, with temperatures in the teens expected along the Gulf Coast this week. It comes as communities from Oregon to the Great Lakes dig out after a weekend of heavy snow, parts of Iowa getting up to 10 inches. Tens of thousands were without power in Wisconsin after the storm dropped more than a foot of snow in some areas. In Colorado, this avalanche along Highway 40 buried at least 10 cars. More than 1,100 flights are canceled already today after more than 1,400 were canceled yesterday. In Kansas City on Saturday, the fourth coldest NFL game ever on record taking place. The temperature at kickoff, -4 degrees with a wind chill of minus 20. Chiefs coach Andy Reid leading his team to victory, even as icicles formed on his mustache. And in western New York, lake effect snow leading to whiteout conditions, forcing officials to postpone the Bills playoff game. The team offering free food and $20 an hour to any fans willing to help clear snow at Highmark Stadium. Yeah! This fan going shirtless as he took a ride down a makeshift snow chute. Rhiannon Alley, ABC News, New York.
Cold, but at least he's having some fun there. It looks like we may be seeing a little snow in our forecast, too. Here's Devin Biggs with the local forecast.
Alrighty, thank you very much. Happy Monday. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home and Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orin, Nome, Maine. Alrighty, here we are this morning. Advisories are posted. Winter storm watches ahead of our next system, which will move in as we head towards a Tuesday and a parts of Tuesday night, accumulating snow possible in this area that we'll need to keep an eye on, though. We also have small craft advisories posted until 4 p.m. Monday, so later today along the coast because of active surf that is being noticed. And the wave heights right now at around 40, even up to 11 feet, according to the buoys out there. So this is why a small craft advisory is posted, at least at this time. But the radar and satellite, again, not too bad after this morning. A few returns on the radar, but within the last few frames, we've been looking pretty good with the partly cloudy sky. We'll see a good amount of sunshine this morning. Then this afternoon, we'll be watching out for a few more clouds that will be moving in. We'll call it a partly cloudy sky today. The activity right now is further off towards the south and west. The system here will be tracking off towards the north and east soon, and that will give us the opportunity for more snow that will begin to move in soon. So it's time to call out a future cast. Overall, a partly cloudy sky will be common today, but otherwise a good amount of sunshine as well. Clouds move in overnight ahead of our next system. The snow moves in perhaps late morning and a parts of the afternoon period for you Tuesday. Most of it should stay as snow, but the system moves just a little bit, though. Maybe some rain along the coast, but most of it should stay as snow Tuesday and a parts of Tuesday evening, but it's a fast mover. It'll be out of here pretty quickly, though, as by Wednesday, this thing will be gone and moving off towards the north and east. Snow accumulations, here's what we're looking at. Roughly 2 to 5 inches of snow before we're all finished up. But notice where that winter storm watch is posted. That's this right about in here. This could range from around 6 to maybe 10 inches of snow in this area here before we're all finished up. But outside in the lighter shades of blue here, around 2 to 5 inches of snow are possible before we're all finished up. Maybe some gusty winds today reaching up to around 15 miles per hour at times. We're backing out all through the afternoon period. Then overnight tonight and parts of tomorrow, we're still looking pretty good. No big issues with the wind at all, at least until our next system begins to move in. So overall for today, we'll call it partly cloudy with highs in the low 30s and that west wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. By tonight, middle teens, mostly cloudy with that west wind getting up to about 5 miles per hour. For tomorrow, 30 degrees, snow showers. We'll say around 2 to 5 inches of snow possible. Locally, higher amounts cannot be ruled out where that winter storm watch is posted with that northeast wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. Alrighty, here's a look at your Scott's Recreation extended forecast. Mostly sunny on Wednesday with highs in the mid-20s. Lower 20s Thursday with a partly cloudy sky. And mostly cloudy on Friday, highs in the low 20s.
Bob's Discount Furniture is doubling down on new with my Tuxedo Power Sofa. Zero gravity power recline, wireless charging in two colors for just $9.99. When you can have a new year for less, there's only one thing to say.
Oh my Bob!
Exciting news. U.S. Cellular has the amazing new iPhone 15 Pro with a stunning titanium design and the best iPhone camera yet. The thing that
Cut.
I love...
Beautiful. Now let's cue the music. Green screen. Huh? And... Action.
U.S. Cellular has the amazing new iPhone.
Come on, man. It's titanium.
U.S. Cellular has the amazing new iPhone.
Cut. Love it.
I felt good. New and current customers can get the iPhone 15 Pro with titanium on us. Get the gift of connection at U.S. Cellular.
Hi, I'm Angelina Mucci.
And I'm Andy Mucci of Family Fun Bowling Center.
When we want to know the weather, we go to foxbangor.com.
Celebrating our 50th anniversary year, Family Fun Bowling Center has 20 lanes of 10-pin bowling at its best.
Celebrate 2024 with a new ride at Quirk Chevrolet in Bangor. Save over $7,000 on 24 Silverado 1500 Custom and buy for $44,495. Or enjoy the new year by saving $23,45 on a new 24 Equinox LT. In the market for a pre-owned vehicle, Quirk Motor City has the next certified car, truck, or SUV you're looking for with over 400 quality used vehicles to choose from. It's your Chevy. Find it at Quirk in Bangor, Portland, and Rockland. Here's to the next 50 years.
Can you spot a bad singer without hearing their voice?
What do you think?
It just surprises me every time.
Fox Wednesdays, I Can See Your Voice is back.
We got to break this down, okay?
Who's a fake lip syncer?
We're being bamboozled by some fancy footwork.
Who's a real talent?
Wow.
And who's taking home $100,000?
Let's see your voice! From the
start to her feet. All new I Can See Your Voice, Wednesdays on Fox, or watch anytime on Hulu.
Now to the so-called Gilgo Beach serial killer, who's now expected to face charges of the murder of another woman in New York. ABC's Lionel Moyes has the latest.
This morning, alleged Gilgo Beach serial killer Rex Huerman is expected to be charged in the death of a fourth woman in New York. Huerman was already the prime suspect in the killing of Maureen Brainard Barnes. The 25-year-old seemingly vanished in 2007. Her remains found in a marshy area near Gilgo Beach 3 years later, wrapped with a belt, which had a buckle bearing the initials WH, possibly standing for Huerman's father. Now, sources say prosecutors are preparing to announce that a grand jury has returned an indictment formally charging Huerman with Brainard Barnes' murder when he returns to court tomorrow.
So there's a lot of evidence we had, but they weren't ready to charge. So now we're 6 months into it, a long time for investigators to work at, and apparently they forwarded the case, so they're going forward Tuesday morning.
Huerman is already charged with killing three women, their bodies found wrapped in burlap on Long Island's South Shore. He's pleaded not guilty to killing Megan Waterman, Melissa Barthelme, and Amber Costello. All three were found dead in December 2010.
It's bittersweet because I know the details of her death. She was just a normal person, and that she had a normal loving heart, just like any person that you walk down next to on the sidewalk, and she didn't deserve this.
Investigators spent days searching Huerman's home over the summer, seizing his cell phone, office storage unit, and even zeroed in on this pizza box, collecting what they say is a critical piece of DNA evidence. Lionel Moyes, ABC News, New York.
And there are six other women whose bodies were found near Gilgo Beach whose deaths remain unsolved. An area known as the skydiving capital of the world was the scene of a tragic accident on Sunday. Four people were killed and one was left fighting for their life following a hot air balloon crash in Arizona. It happened in a desert area called Eloy, about 65 miles southeast of Phoenix. 13 people went up in the balloon, including 8 skydivers. After the skydivers jumped, something happened to cause the balloon to deflate quickly and crash.
Shortly thereafter, something catastrophic occurred with the balloon, causing it to crash to the ground.
They saw the last 10 seconds before the impact, and they said that the material of the balloon portion was just straight up.
Our affiliate also talked to family.
Three of the four people who were killed all died after being brought to the hospital. The mayor of Eloy says the area is a popular location for skydivers. He describes it as a very well-known and loved area among enthusiasts, and that when something like this happens, if in the community, it affects everyone. The nurse you see there on the screen is among those killed in the crash. The FAA is now investigating. Well, now to the caucuses in Iowa, where months of campaigning have all led up to this point. Candidates are out in full force today as the state continues to get slammed by the frigid cold. Former President Donald Trump making his final pitch to voters while tempering expectations of his predicted landslide victory. Nikki Haley and Ron DeSantis, meanwhile, in a desperate race for second place. ABC's M. Wynn has the latest.
Here, after months of campaigning, the first in the nation Iowa caucuses. Sub-zero temperatures and blustery winds still slamming the Hawkeye state. GOP frontrunner Donald Trump rallying Sunday, downplaying the weather.
It's all indoors, so you're not going to have to worry about that.
The former president, who faces 91 criminal charges, imploring his supporters to deliver him a decisive victory.
The big event at 7 o'clock, and hopefully we're going to have some tremendous numbers.
Trump holding a dominant 28-point lead in a new Des Moines Register NBC News poll. Nikki Haley and Ron DeSantis now in a heated race for second place. Haley with their
really
Eva Pilgrim.
What I love about the poll is I was the only one going up and everybody else was going down. So
Haley canceling an event Sunday with DeSantis nearby, still in person, pushing the idea that he, not Haley, is the only candidate who can beat Trump.
She cannot win conservative or core voters, Republican. She's trying to win, you know, people in the other party.
In Des Moines, his supporters going door to door trying to win over new voters as his poll numbers decline.
Got another one.
Arkansas Governor Asa Hutchinson still in the race, but polling in the single digits, criticizing the other presidential hopefuls for not aiming their attacks at Trump.
Candidates that think they're going to win without taking on Donald Trump, they're behind 28 points in the polls. So we'll see what strategy works.
The caucuses begin tonight with the power to reshape a presidential race. Here in the media room, media outlets from across the globe will be able to see results and report them out in real time. M1, ABC News, Des Moines, Iowa.
In other news, a huge pro-Palestine demonstration taking place today in the nation's capital as the war between Israel and Hamas reaches the 100-day mark. Tens of thousands calling on the U.S. to drop its support for Israel's assault on Gaza. Fox News Chief Washington Correspondent Mike Emanuel has more.
Protesters calling for a ceasefire in Gaza and demanding the United States stop supporting Israel's military action. Protesters have been passionate all afternoon long. A huge crowd bust in from places like Wisconsin, Minnesota, Florida, and Texas. One of three Muslim lawmakers in Congress addressed those who are saddened by the war and its impact on the Palestinian people.
Now, it's human to feel anger and grief and even hopelessness. But today, we should be hopeful. Because I see power. For you are the movement that helped to achieve a temporary ceasefire. It was you.
The timing of this event is to nearly 100 days of war in Gaza, and some speakers have made reference to the Dr. Martin Luther King holiday as well. One highlighting Dr. King's famous line that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Protesters are here for a variety of reasons. Some are clearly pro-Palestinian. Others are from anti-war organizations. We've been asking them why many have traveled to be here today.
I think we have that innate sense of fighting spirit and freedom within us, and it's important for me to be there for my brothers and sisters in Palestine as well.
While this protest is taking place near the White House, it's important to note President Biden is not here. He's at Camp David for the weekend, but it's clear many folks want U.S. policymakers to hear their perspective. In Washington, Mike Emanuel, Fox News.
Protest happening yesterday. Well, meanwhile, the Pentagon says Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin remains hospitalized and is in good condition. Tomorrow will mark 2 weeks since the 70-year-old was rushed to the hospital following complications from surgery for prostate cancer on December 22nd. His doctor says Austin was treated for a urinary tract infection related to the operation. News that the Pentagon chief had undergone two hospitalizations and surgeries without immediately notifying the White House or Pentagon staff has caused an uproar. The White House says President Biden only learned about the cancer diagnosis on Tuesday. They're trying to make changes, so whenever the secretaries of any of the departments have to be hospitalized, they'll kind of let everybody else know what's going on. All right, coming up on the second half of the newscast, we'll hear why the Hertz rental business is selling its electric car fleet. We'll also hear important advice that can help us cut down on our credit card debt. Those stories and more as Good Morning Maine continues.
Fishing trip hit a snag? Won't stop us. In a Nissan SUV, adventure begins where the road ends.
Drive a Nissan SUV. Get 1.9% financing for 60 months on the 2023 Nissan Rogue.
A family-owned and operated business since 1953, Hammond Lumber Company recognizes the value of their team members and the importance of employee satisfaction. Hammond is honored to have been named one of the best places to work in Maine for 3 years running. This year, Hammond was selected as one of the best companies to work for by Business New Hampshire magazine. Hammond is always looking for great people to join their team. To find your place on the Hammond team, click on the careers link at hammondlumber.com.
Fishing trip hit a snag? Won't stop us. In a Nissan SUV, adventure begins where the road ends.
Drive a Nissan SUV. Get 1.9% financing for 60 months on the 2023 Nissan Rogue.
You're watching Fox 22, Bangor.
Welcome back, everyone. Today is Monday, January 15th, 2024. It is also Martin Luther King Day. It was on this day in 1983 that President Ronald Reagan approved a national holiday to honor the slain civil rights leader. Lawmakers had considered the idea for years, but many were concerned about the cost of giving federal workers a paid day off, and also that a holiday to honor a private citizen would be contrary to long-standing tradition. But support continued to build, and the Martin Luther King Day was first observed in 1986. All right, on this day in history, back in 1870, a cartoon by Thomas Nast appeared in Harper's Weekly with a donkey symbolizing the Democratic Party for the first time. It was 4 years later when Nast drew a cartoon using an elephant to depict the Republican Party, and it has been used ever since. In 1892, Dr. James Naismith published the rules of basketball. He invented the game at the YMCA in Springfield, Massachusetts. In 1943, the Pentagon was dedicated on the Virginia side of the Potomac River outside Washington, D.C. It is the world's largest office building and includes 17 miles of corridors. In 1967, the first Super Bowl was played in Los Angeles, pitting the Green Bay Packers against the Kansas City Chiefs. The Packers ended up winning 35-10. In 1975, Space Mountain opened at Walt Disney World in Florida and continues to this day. In 2009, the Miracle on the Hudson took place. That's when pilot Chesley Sully Sullenberger managed to safely land a U.S. Airways jet on the Hudson River after it struck a flock of Canadian geese. And finally, in 2019, the World Economic Forum announced that there will be more plastic than fish in our oceans as early as 2050. Well, today's birthdays include rapper Pitbull, who is 43 years old. He dazzled the crowd last summer when he came to Bangor. Disney Channel star Dove Cameron is 28 years old today. And as we reported, this is also the birthday of civil rights leader Martin Luther King Jr., who was born on this date in 1929 in Atlanta, Georgia. By the way, they're going to have a special breakfast to honor Martin Luther King and to remember his teachings this morning at the University of Maine. That breakfast will take place from 8:30 until 10:30. Time for a check of our forecast now. Looks like a quiet start to the work week. We may see a little snow from time to time, but overall, no big deal. Here's Devin.
Alrighty, thank you very much. Happy Monday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. As we get into things this morning, we have some advisories already posted ahead of our next system that will be moving in. This right here is a winter storm watch that's posted until 2 a.m. Wednesday morning. The snow's going to be moving in throughout the day Tuesday and a part of Tuesday evening, so some accumulating snow possible, especially in this area, though, although most of us will see some kind of accumulating snow before it wraps up. We also have a small kite advisory up through today until 4 p.m. along the coast because of active surf along the coast. As for the radar and satellite, we're looking pretty quiet out there now, just some clouds passing through. A few returns up on the radar as well, but otherwise I think we're staying dry out there with at least a partly cloudy sky, and will remain partly cloudy throughout the daytime period today, so we will see some sunshine as we have this system that has since tracked off towards the north and east, some more activity near Washington, D.C., but otherwise for us. We're looking pretty good. We will be under a partly cloudy sky today, as Futurecast indicates. Later on tonight, more clouds will begin to approach as that next system begins to get a little bit closer. As for the winds, a few areas reaching up to around 5 to 10 miles per hour at times, maybe a few higher gusts along the coast, but things will start to calm down later on tonight. But as this next system moves in, maybe some more gusty winds to watch out for. So at hourly forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period, a lot of sunshine, partly cloudy otherwise later this afternoon, temperatures in the 30s. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up.
All right, thank you, Devin. A rental car company is parting with some of its electric vehicles, and some EV seekers could save some big bucks. Hertz is selling about 20,000 electric vehicles as it makes changes to move some of its fleet to gasoline-powered models. More than 600 Teslas are up for sale, including recent Model 3s and Model Ys. Prices are as low as $21,000. The savings for potential buyers could be up to 39%. And buyers of used EVs are eligible to get a $4,000 tax credit. Hertz apparently saying they are dealing with the high cost of repairing and maintaining those vehicles, and they don't want to deal with those electric vehicles anymore. When we come back, all the day sports news. Don't go away.
Jerry's Used Cars has been a family-owned business for more than 30 years, currently in Corinna and Vesey. However, we have changed a little as we are no longer just a buy-here, pay-here dealership. We now have access to outside financing and also carry utility trailers. We would be happy to assist you with your next vehicle purchase. And don't forget, here at Jerry's Used Cars, we offer an extended warranty. So give us a call at either our Corinna or Vesey location.
If you think about it, hash browns are the French fries of breakfast.
Who says it's not French fries that are the hash browns of lunch and dinner?
That's also true.
Right now, you can get a savory, melty sausage burrito, crunchy hash browns, or these satisfying breakfast faves. Mix and match any two for just $3 at McDonald's.
CEM DP Porter Contractors has been in business for over 40 years in the Bangor area. We specialize in commercial, medical, and residential design build construction, as well as building maintenance and renovations. CEM DP Porter Contractors is currently hiring in Herman for multiple positions, including carpenters and a project manager superintendent. We offer vacation, holidays, a 3% IRA match, competitive pay, and a family-oriented environment. If interested in applying, please contact Jason at 848-7486.
Winter is flu season, and not only that, but COVID is still with us, as is RSV. Remember, it takes your body about 2 weeks after you get any vaccination to ramp up those antibodies. Now is the time for you and your family to get vaccinated against the flu, COVID, and RSV. Updated vaccines are now available for flu and COVID-19, and depending on your age, active steps you can take to prevent RSV. Talk to your doctor or pharmacist, or go to vaccines.gov. A message from the Maine CDC, this station, and the Maine Association of Broadcasters.
Local news weeknights at 10 with Beth Jones and Peter Dubois on Fox 22.
Hey everybody, Ryan Sudol here. Thank you so much for joining us. After Maine football lineman David Gross's career came to an end this year due to injuries, he still wanted to stay in the game. What a better way to do that than teaching the next generation. Gross and Queen City Athletics owner Sean DeMary, another former Black Bear, have started the off-season lineman academy at the center in Vesey with one-on-one sessions plus group ones for grades 3 to 12 every Monday this month. They teach blocking, mobility, all the basics to get to the next level. A huge point of pride for Gross is that the academy gives kids opportunities that he never had.
Something that Maine doesn't have is an offensive and defensive line specific coach, like across the whole state. And I realized that because 4 years ago I was in the same situation as them. I approached Sean and I was like, listen, I just want to find a way to get back to the community. Sean and I were fortunate enough to learn a lot about football at the University of Maine, and we're in a great position to do something that the state of Maine just doesn't have.
To say it's been a success is an understatement. Within less than a week, nearly a dozen kids signed up for one-on-ones, with even more signing up for the group sessions. Gross is humbled by the response, and it only further justifies why he wants to go all in with this new endeavor.
response we've had across the state. It's been truly a blessing, like, to have so many people reach out. I want to buy into this, man. I want to build these kids all the way through. I'm working a lot of middle school kids right now. I want to see them get into high school and excel. Okay, it's really hard to get college attention up here in Maine, so anything that I can help these kids just to get better and excel and get some exposure, that's what I want to do.
Great stuff right there, and a great guy. Let's move on to Maine men's hockey now. After Friday night's crazy comeback win against UConn down in Hartford, the 7th-ranked Black Bears looking for the weekend sweep on Saturday. Black Bears also looking to extend their 9-game unbeaten streak. First period, just 2 shots on goal for UConn, and it was because of defense like this. Anthony Calafiore gets in front of 2 shot attempts in a matter of seconds, scoreless after 1. A bunch more shots for UConn in the second period, but reigning Hockey East goalie of the week, Albin Boya, keeps the sheet clean. Nice glove save there. Under 30 seconds into the third period now, UConn's Tabor Heaslip from behind the net wraps it around and sneaks it past Boya. It is 1-0 Huskies. Couple minutes later, UConn's Tristan Frazier works the puck out of a scrum, sends it to Joey Muldowney in front, and he 5-holes it for the goal. It's 2-0 UConn, and that is your final. Maine loses for the first time since November. And meanwhile, over at the Alphon, Maine women's hockey looking for the sweep over number 14 Northeastern after their win on Friday. First period, Maine's Michaela Borders clearance attempt ends up with the Huskies' Megan Carter, but her shot is saved with a glove by Jordan Madison. A couple minutes later, Northeastern's Avery Anderson pokes it away from Jamie Grinder, gets control, shoots, and scores. It is 1-0 Northeastern. Later in the first, Maine's Lily Fetch to Kennedy Little. She sends it in. It ricochets off number 3 there, Sam Morrison. She gets credit for the goal. It's 1-1. No scores the next 2 periods or overtime. It's a tie, but the shootout for the extra Hockey East point. Maine's Anne Frederique Gay has to score to extend the shootout, but Gwyneth Phillips says no. Northeastern gets 2 Hockey East points out of the 1-1 tie. Maine, 1 point. Okay, now let's move to some college basketball. A NAC doubleheader for Houston men and women's basketball on Saturday down at SUNY Canton. It started with the women's game in the morning. Eagles looking for their 4th straight win here. Third quarter, Houston leading. Sophia McVicker off the inbound, the pass inside to Bailey Donovan. Nice fadeaway to put the Eagles up double digits. But late in the fourth, the Roos stage a comeback. 90 seconds left in regulation. Tori Moore to Sierra Pabo. The runner is good to tie the game up at 68. It's tied at 70 now with 50 seconds to go. Husson's Hannah Richards to McKaylin Porter. Her baseline floater goes down and Husson takes the lead. Canton foul shots tie the game again, and now Pabo has it with 5 seconds, a chance to win, but she's fouled on the drive. She sinks the ensuing free throws, and Husson drops a heartbreaker, 74-72. And then came the men's game, the Eagles looking to stay perfect in NAC play here. Late first half, Eagles in transition with the lead. Riles Neff, nice pass over to Jeremy Maranta on the wing, and he drains the 3. Later on, a steal by Canton's Brennan Harmer. He hurls it down to Kevin Good Jr. up for the layup, and he is fouled hard, but still gets it to go. Husson up 2 at the half. Roos start the second on a run. Eagles cutting into it here. Neff, a straight on 3, and it's good to pull it within 6. 2-point game now with under a minute left. Javonte Williams trying to give the Roos some breathing room, and the off-balance shot is good off glass. SUNY Canton sweeps Husson. The men win it 82-78. And that's all the time we have for sports. We'll be right back after the break.
Let's face it, getting training and experience is hard, but at Loring Job Corps, we can help. From certifications in automotive technology, obtaining your CDL, or learning building trades, we have you covered. Maybe you prefer joining the high-tech world of computer networking or cybersecurity. We have that as well. Don't delay. Get in the driver's seat to your future today. And the best part? Loring Job Corps is free. Receive free training, free meals, and even free housing. Call or go to jobcorps.gov/loring. Job Corps careers begin here.
Discover new opportunities together in a new Chevy. Meet up in an award-winning Equinox. Lend a hand in the Silverado with up to 14 available camera views. Or mix it up in the Trax with an 11-inch diagonal display screen. Find the Chevy that's right for you. Current Chevy owners can get $6,000 total cash allowance on this Silverado when you trade in an eligible vehicle. Or current qualified lessees can get this Silverado for around $389 a month.
My father started a roofing company in the 1970s.
Back when asbestos was still commonly used in Maine.
When George was diagnosed with mesothelioma, We knew there wasn't a cure yet, but we knew he needed help.
We called Jeb Bornstein's office because this family means business.
Their team is handling everything, representing Mainers who were victims of asbestos exposure.
We highly recommend the law offices of Joe Bornstein.
Call Joe today for a free case evaluation. There's never a fee unless you win.
Roto-Rooter has served the greater Bangor area and beyond for 35 years, offering plumbing, hydrojetting, snaking, descaling, video inspection, and grease interceptor cleaning services. For all your residential and commercial clogs, call Roto-Rooter today, 990-1234.
And away go troubles down the drain. Roto-Rooter.
Credit cards can be a great tool. With just a quick tap, we can make a transaction and worry about where the money's coming from later. But millions of Americans have racked up debt on their credit accounts. Here's ABC's Melissa Aiden with some help on how to manage and pay off that credit card debt.
A new report from NerdWallet found that Americans owe a total of $1.21 trillion in credit card debt.
This year, we found that credit card debt is up 16% compared to a year ago. And that's not the only form of borrowing that costs more. Mortgages, student loans, and auto loans are also up, which is putting a lot of people in a very tough situation when it comes to being able to repay those loans.
NerdWallet's Sarah Rathner says the first step to paying down debt is to make a list of all the amounts you owe and the interest rate for each debt, then make a debt payoff plan.
And that idea is to keep you motivated and organized while you make debt payments.
One popular method is debt avalanche, where you prioritize the debt with the highest interest rate first, then move to the debt with the next highest interest rate on your list. Or you could try a debt snowball, where you focus on the debt with the lowest balance and keep moving your way up to higher balances. Rathner says you can also try to lower the interest rates on your cards.
Start by calling the number on the back of your credit card and talk to somebody in customer service and see if you'd be eligible for a lower credit card interest rate.